So what are JVs? Traditionally, JVs, or joint venture partners, simply refer to people who came together to cooperate and share in a business venture. Today, especially in the internet marketing or IM world, it means something a little different. JV has actually become shorthand for affiliate, or someone who sends traffic to your offer and is paid a commission for each sale they make. Frankly, this has caused a little confusion, because even in IM, you can still have a JV partnership in the traditional sense. For example, if you have a video course and ebook you created but no skills or means for getting it online, you could partner with someone who will do the web design and development and split the profits 50-50. The fact that those two JV partners will usually start recruiting affiliates to drive traffic to their product while calling those affiliates JVs makes things even more confusing. Especially when you consider that those two JV partners in the traditional sense will split profits after payouts are made to their JVs or affiliates in the new sense of the word. This happens all the time in IM, and so it's difficult to know what a person means when they say, "Would you like to be my JV?" But today, for whatever reason, 9 times out of 10, a person simply means affiliate. Honestly, conflating the terms was a horrible mistake on the part of the IM community. That said, since it's become the norm, in this guide we'll be using the term JV to refer to affiliates. Clear as mud? Good, let's move on. So let's talk about why JVs are better than paid ads for your product launch. There's plenty of ways to drive traffic today. But generally, when you need to drive large amounts of it, you'll be using paid methods. In many industries, the standard is, of course, paid advertising methods such as pay-per-click, or PPC. Now, this is a little bit risky because you're paying out money for traffic without a guarantee that those clicks you paid for will convert to sales. So you're risking loss, and you have little or no control over what your ROI will be. For example, you might pay $200 for 2 clicks and only make $210 from the handful of sales you made. It's great that you at least broke even, but you had no control over that outcome. And in the next campaign, you might make back even less than you spent. You can still make this model work, obviously, but it requires a lot of testing, tweaking, adjusting, and a ton of ad spend just to get to the point where you've optimized and gained better control over your expected ROI. That's perfectly fine if you're a big business with a huge advertising budget, but not so much if you're an independent online entrepreneur. Now compare that model to the JV or affiliate model. When you do a JV-driven product launch, you don't have to worry about ad spend. You're only paying for successful sales after they happen, and you know in advance what amount you're paying per sale. You also don't have to spend any time or money testing and tweaking and targeting. You're handing all that hard work over to the JVs with their own lists and their own audiences that they already know well and know how to pitch and market to. When you compare the two, clearly the JV or affiliate model holds an advantage, especially if you're an independent entrepreneur and not a business with a big advertising budget. Bottom line, if you want to launch a digital product, you need JVs sending traffic to your offer, or you can kiss your dreams of having a big buyer's list goodbye. The question is, how do you attract these JVs? It all starts with having an awesome JV recruiting page, and that's what we'll cover next. Now, before you start generating buzz about your launch among JVs, you need somewhere to send them. Now, theoretically, at an absolute minimum, you could send them directly to the JV or affiliate registration page for the marketplace or affiliate platform you're using, such as JVZoo or Warrior Plus. However, sending people directly to these affiliate details pages would be unlikely to encourage signups. Instead, what you need to do is show or tell them why they should promote your product, as well as provide them with tools and resources to help them promote your product as easily as possible. The way you do this is by creating a JV page. A JV page should ideally have the following components: an invite video, a visualization of your sales funnel, a breakdown of your commission model, a list of contest prizes, a contest leaderboard, an opt-in form for your JV email list, a collection of done-for-you bonuses, a bonus page template, a supply of email swipes, a collection of banners and graphics, a JV blog, a link to a sales page preview, and a prominent affiliate sign-up button. Let's take a look at each of these more closely. Your JV invite video is the most effective if it features you in talking head format. You should describe your product thoroughly as well as all the details of your launch. This means you should mention your funnel and commission model, your contests and prizes, and so on. Ultimately, your video should end by thanking JVs for considering your launch and repeating your invitation, specifically with an explicit call to action to sign up as an affiliate. Now let's talk about your funnel and commission model. Your sales funnel diagram would typically be the same place that you lay out your commission model. Ideally, you should have a graphical representation of each step in your funnel indicating all the upsells and downsells along with the commission percentage for each of those steps and the price of each of those products. Include any different pricing options you have for each of those products. You may specify what each step or product is on this diagram, or it's also acceptable to simply label them as OTO1 or OTO2, but expect some JVs to contact you and ask you what those...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.